So that hopefully we'll have time to try to make a journey over to Micro Center, start buying some equipment for the IRL stream. Yeah, DreamHack's gonna be 99% ley lines, huh? Okay, posing turn one saga. Still usually means Titan, but could be a few different decks. Second copy of Lightning Bolt is not terrible, but I think I'm supposed to be digging for like Phoenix, Shredder, Swift Spear. Titan. A lot of Titan today. You have the Magus in the sideboard, although in our challenge, our last round of the challenge this week, it was not enough to bail us out. The Magus in the sideboard not enough to bail us out. I guess I'll Mutagenic Growth here, try to find Delirium. Oh, although starting the turn with Metamorphosis next turn is just too good. Yeah, it's just way too good. With Triple Channeler in play, forget about it. Although, I may just be dead on turn three. I guess I need like an Amulet or Grazer. Okay, first land drop is not a bounce land, so I'm feeling okay. Hopefully we can find a Lava Dart and go Bolt Dart that Dryad this turn. And then just attack for 9 twice. Although I guess if they have Titan next turn, they can Bajuka Bog me. But I get this awesome turn. I'm gonna graveyard almost everything here. I don't even like know what card I'd be keeping on top. Because I just want to like be binning Phoenixes and Lava Darts. There's a Dart. There's a Phoenix. Awesome, awesome. Blue Red. Into another Metamorphosis. Let's get all 4 Phoenixes in play here. Let's get all 4 Phoenixes. I'm here for it. Just graveyard literally any card. Except, I guess Metamorphosis is actually the only card to keep on top. Thanks for the 11 months. Appreciate you, buddy. Are you going to DreamHack Dallas or no? Maybe it was actually better to use the mana for darts. Yeah, I can't cast this Metamorphosis. This is probably fine to keep on top for the iteration specifically. So go hand, bottom, exile. Only one Phoenix so far, but we're gonna get to flip over a lot more of our deck. Come on, okay, come on. Oh, I was really happy to hit that first Phoenix, and now I'm like, only one Phoenix? This is ridiculous. I've gone through 33 cards of my library and only hit one Phoenix. All right. I guess I'll save the bobble for if they bog me. All right, not about turn three. Oh, wait, yeah. Could I just have killed them? No, I think I was one mana short, right? Yeah, I was one damage short. I should have looked at just bolting them, though. Ryan, Twitch Prime, appreciate you. Oh, I didn't sing. I'm sorry. When you redeem the redemption in between rounds, I'm very likely to forget. I'll sing the next card, probably. I'll try to. Do I have another dart? Oh, I did have another dart. Sorry, I should have darted again. Yeah, messed it up. Oh, I don't even get to draw my next card now, though. Ugh. Killed me with this redemption timing. I'll just play 2 grudge, 2 darts. Or maybe 3 grudge, 2 dart, 3 salvaging. Okay, I'm going to sing the first card on my left, because I also away from mulligans and stuff. Do I brew legacy decks so well? I used to be like a primarily legacy player before I started streaming. I was really into the format then. I never really brewed much in the format. I brewed sometimes, but never super successfully. Mostly just like would tweak existing lists. But yeah, it's really hard to be like as in tune with like with it's hard to be super in tune with two formats at once and be like actively brewing in both. No more Blood Moon. No, I like Magus of the Moon more because of Abyss Age. Spider, 22 months. Appreciate you. Aren't 16 creatures, 4 baubles too much for phoenixes? I don't think so. I'm not of the opinion that they are. Say it's like about the maximum, but I've liked this list a lot. Especially when like Lava Dart is like really good to like just get you those two spells and you can like surveil and like when specifically Channeler and Shredder play really well with Phoenix, there's like a lot of synergy there. I'm not too worried about it. Is Buried Alive too good for Modern? Dude, I would love to Buried Alive some Phoenixes. Can't keep this double grudge nonsense on the draw. One land. If I had Demon Lich with Shredder in this deck, I haven't. I don't think it's good because like to play Demon Lich, you have to play like tons of like one mana blue cantrips, which I don't think the deck has room to support. It's pretty close between putting back Grudge and Iteration. I think I'll put back the Iteration because the Shredder is going to give me some card advantage here. Cool. Happy to have that now. Oh, doubly happy. Although, yeah, I can't even Shredder turn two. It's too slow. I have to Grudge. Oh, sorry. I keep not singing. Scalding Tarn! Sorry, I don't know. You gotta time the sing redemptions. You have to give me like 30 seconds because I just forget after any longer than that. Buried Alive for Karma Guide, Kikijiki, Feldar Guardian. Yeah, you can also like put like Priest of Fel Rites in those piles, but it's pretty slow and probably easy to play around. I think just main phase the Grudge here. They shouldn't, you know, obviously they could theoretically Titan, but they would need like third amulet in their hand or like multiple grazers or like Azusa plus grazer plus Titan, which is not that likely. Karn on the other hand is like super obnoxious. It's so awkward to have a bobble in my hand against this Karn, but also pretty hard to play around. You find that you take more damage with other decks in playing land. Yeah, this deck does deal with stuff with a lot of damage, but usually aggro decks are the most capable, or aggro decks are like it's okay to take more damage because you're putting pressure on your opponent, and in that ways you play defense because it's hard for your opponent to also put pressure on you. They decide just to tick up on the Karn. Well, I think I have to kill the amulet so like their Karn is worse. Of course I draw a second Bobble when they put the freaking card in play. So frustrating. Of course, right? No other outcome was ever possible here. If I get the Phoenix here, if I bin Phoenix, then there's a good chance that they're just going to... Yeah, let me actually bin Swift Spear. So next turn I can go Phoenix, Bobble, attack Karn for like up to 6. I can't crack these Bobbles either, but like the Bobble, let me go Phoenix, Bobble, Connive, I think makes sense. Yeah, maybe they'll just plus up my Bobble. Maybe for the 22 months? Yeah, I probably should have better posture, huh? But whenever time I see someone say posture check in the chat, I just did like, no. You can't make me sit up straight. Why did I play Bobble there? I did play the Bobble to trigger Connive on the Ledger Shredder. And then I'm holding the second Bobble to trigger Connive on the Ledger Shredder next turn. Isn't it just better to Grudge, hold double Bobble for guaranteed loot? Oh yeah, I guess maybe I could have just triggered Connive off the Grudge. Maybe that was better. Previous version of Phoenix of Modern said Demon Lich was the best card in the deck. Yeah, but that's like, you have to understand, like, this deck and that other Phoenix version are very different, where This is a red-based Prowess deck that's playing Lava Dart and Lightning Bolt and Monastery Swift Spear, Mutagenic Growth. Very, very aggressive version here. But when you compare that, like, Dimulich is not good in this version. Dimulich, you need to be playing, like, millions of blue cantrips, right? Like, and you need to be playing, you know, millions of, like, cheap blue cantrips here. And obviously, like, you could potentially find a version of the deck that can do both. But I think that it's better to, like, probably divorce the two decks and, like, say that this version is very good and grindy, resilient to removal, has a lot of card selection, is very good against creature decks, is very good against fair decks. And then this deck is more resilient to hate, is more explosive, is more aggressive, and they're just, you know, different archetypes. Okay, they do minus the Karn for an Engineered Explosives, and they don't play it on zero. They're probably going to play it on two. So I guess now... No, we have to play the Phoenix. Do I play the Bauble, though? I think I play the Bauble. I want to crack them. I think I'm looting that away. It's kind of close. And I guess I crack... Oh my gosh, what the heck just happened? No! No, damn it. So frustrating. The freaking Magic Online lag. Oh, I said my DreamHack deck. I'm really leaning towards the Esper Food deck. I'm also considering this one, so I'm just kind of running it through one more league first. Yeah, Karn gets to kill a Bauble. I'm too fast. It's just Magic Online lag, where I accidentally double-click it. Magic Online doesn't update to show me that it's not unattacked, and then I click OK to go to combat, and then it just, like, untaps it before it, like, visually is in play. It's like, it's just, like, impossible to play around, I think. Yeah, we did play Esper Food today. Three leagues. We're 11-4. Just lost the Bauble. I'll have to kill the Karn again. It's just such a disaster. Clip, can I get a refund? I guess, but, like, the refund is, like, not worth nearly as much to me as, like, streaming good gameplay, you know what I mean? That's, like, that's actually what's, you know, frustrating to me here. Endurance. Well, let's hope they don't have a Titan. All the bubbles. We should have one more card in their hand too, but we just don't. Their life total should be lower. Coulda, woulda, shoulda, I guess. Alright, let's go to game three. Oh no, am I dead? Yeah, well, I would have been dead to that being in hand, right? But if somehow I'm not dead and I top deck Magus of the Moon, I do win. I even get some, like, looks at a Magus of the Moon here. I had a bug like this one time. I was like 2-1 in a PTQ, and I had a bug like this, or, you know, the. What even? What? How does that even happen?
Oh my gosh! What the heck just happened? No.
There's actually, like, what did I click wrong? I must have double clicked. Shout out to the player who said I played too fast, you know what I mean? what am I supposed to do? Game three. Go to game three is what I'm supposed to do here. I don't know if, like, that's the difference between this game or not, but obviously, like, just put us really behind. Gross. Why did Poe not kill me there? I think that once they Like, once they played the crumbling vantage from their hands, or the crumbling whatever, like, they messed up and then they couldn't kill me. They had extra lens drop from Dryad. I thought they used it on the crumb. They messed up for sure, but I think, like, they didn't realize they could kill me. Obviously, like, at some extent, they didn't realize they messed up, right? It's not really any deeper than that. Hey, Mulligan. Haven't just, like, had a hand with a Magus yet. This hand's kind of slow. We are on the play. We have three lands. I think I'll keep, just, like, try to dig for a Magus. Can I explain the sideboard? That's a bit too general of a question, especially when we've, you know, kind of gone over it a few times, too. There will be a deck guide on Channel Fireball. They'll, you know, give you a sideboard guide later this week. But if you have a more specific question about some cards on the sideboard, I can't answer, yeah. But can you explain the sideboard? It's just too general of a question for me to answer. How am I liking Invasive? I literally haven't played against a Cascade deck once since playing this deck. I feel like in theory, though, both Rhinos and Living End are scary matchups, and I really want to hedge very heavily against them. I feel like that, in theory, again, is a card that really makes a lot of sense for that plan. But they also seem to be sort of like wards. I could put the Phoenix in the hand and loot it away for some value, but that's probably a bit too narrow, huh? I guess it's also a bit awkward. I can't Saga kill the... or Magus kill the Saga. Is what it is. The magic puzzle, some of the chess puzzles. Yeah, some people post content like that. I usually think it's pretty cool. How about the four color decks, the elementals, and the blink control, Cindy Ball alternative. Seem to alternate, Sunnyder's a lot of blink, lots of elementals. Yeah, like I don't think that there's really, like, to be honest. Like, you know, the difference is, like, you either play Risen Reef or you don't. You know, it's like Risen, some people like Risen Reef in the flex spot is how I like to view it, and some people don't like Risen Reef in the flex spot. I think I'll hold the Metamorphose for next turn, so I could play blue mana after the Magus. If they have a Dismember, though, this is kind of scary. Then I think I discard Bobble here, actually. Why is it called 8 Bird with Phoenix isn't Bird? That's just, like, blatant, awful clickbait. Elementals is better than the pseudo mirror. That makes sense. I think that is something I would believe. I'm just gonna graveyard that. Still make blue mana here, but just casting the second Magus seems to be probably game over. So I'm gonna try not to find a way to lose a game that shouldn't be losable. Although we may just have lethal here. Should I go for surveilling another Phoenix into the yard? I don't really see why not, but we just have lethal even without the without anything. I think it's good habits to be just, like, surveilling aggressively for a Phoenix on these turns where you, like, go all in.
All right, despite that awful bug, game 2, you win game 3. Oh. No, this isn't enough by itself. They need something else.
Okay. Well, they probably should have Endurance before my Phoenix came back, huh? And then in the more interactive matchups, like specifically Ragavan and Control, you'll just trim some copies. So I think it makes way more sense to be more in on it game 1 to improve your bad matchups, and then in sideboard games, you get to improve your good matchups just by trimming some copies. What do you think is four colors worst matchup? It might be the food deck. I'm currently I have, like, some absurd win rate against food with Okay, so next turn I think I'm gonna cast Salvaging, not Swift Spear, so I'll cast the Bobble too. I have some crazy record. Alright, let's cast that next turn then. Sorry, I have a crazy record against four color on Math with Food. I think I'm like actually like 8-0 or 9-0 or something. I do think, like, you know, you do have to like learn how to play the food deck. The food deck has like a high learning curve, so I don't know that you'll necessarily just pick it up and start winning, but that would be my pick though. So maybe I should still cast the Salvaging this turn. Although, no, we'll cast the Shredder, because if I cast the Salvaging this turn, I don't get to connive next turn because the upkeep Salvaging. Gotta imagine that they have Ephemerate here. Although I guess they messed up. They weren't supposed to let me get a connive. Not that, you know, the connive is like game ending or game winning or anything, but they also don't get to get a third creature, Solitude Ephemerate. They only have two cards in their hand because I think they're on a mulligan. Yeah, they're on a mulligan to six. With Phoenix in the yard now, kind of not the end of the world. A few cards I don't want to see here though. Is this version just better than the Dimulich variant, or are they different enough to play with the Dimulich version? I would say that the Dimulich version has much more polarizing matchups, where the Dimulich version like crushes Hammer Time and Murktide and Control and other like cheap Ragavan decks, while having like pretty poor matchup against like most Cascade combo big mana. Well, this deck seems to have like much more even matchup spread. So I would probably say different rather than one just being better or worse than another, but you know, that also means that you're going to want to choose, you know, some for metagame, some for other metagames, blah 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 blah. I gotta kill the reef, I guess. Two cards in opponent's hand, so has access to Yorion. Yorion pretty scary here. Teferi pretty scary. Hope that they attack, which they probably will, so I can kill the Teferi with Swift Spear. Yeah, it's pretty hard for them to play around Swift Spear here. They also tapped their mana wrong. So we'll go Shredder, Swift Spear. I think we just discard the Tarn. Then we get to play DRC. And with Teferi dead, or hopefully dead, we can upkeep Salvaging and get a little bit of card disadvantage. DRC does have Delirium. They're at 24 life though, and they get to attack with Solitude again, and this like Yorion's gonna be a nightmare. And they still have three other cards in hand. Leaving Solitude back to block Swift Spear, I think, is probably a mistake, because like I'm wanting to bolt this anyways because of the Yorion. Although they left with mana up, so they have either Counterspell, Endurance, Eldarmi's Call, or like Odawara. So if they had Counterspell, you think they might have countered that, but they didn't. I am flooding out a little bit despite surveilling a land into the yard. I have drawn two lands for turn, which sucks. Endurance is going to get me no matter what, so I think I just don't play around it here. Yeah, game two. Yeah, I know we had Giganta. Stinks to 17 land deck, surveil land to the yard, draw two lands, womp womp. This matchup, I may just be no changes. Hope they're on some bolts. Don't think I really want Magus, don't want more Mutagenics, don't want any of the counter spells. Would it make it sense to have a couple lightning axes in 75? I don't know. I don't really think so. Like, I don't even know that, like you, one for wanting your elementals opponent is not how you win this matchup, you know. Reactive answers, like, you just need to be a bit more proactive. Yeah, I also shredded a land, that's true. Basic surgery for Cascade decks. Omnath needs to go, right? Deck is miserable. I mean, I would weep no tears for an Omnath ban. I'm not advocating for it either. 81 card special. The deck has a lot of, the deck is like, you know, the card is like miserable like for a lot of people's pet decks in my experience without actually being too broken. I'm gonna YOLO this keep. This is actually, I think, a fine keep. We just go turn one, hit my opponent for seven, and then try to burn him out. Hopefully no Solitude. My take is Abundant Growth is as toxic as Astrolabe. I mean, it is like, it's a conversation for sure. I think Astrolabe is like way better. Like, the fact that it's castable off of every basic land, it makes Ice Fang have Death Touch turn two. Like, Astrolabe is certainly the better of the two cards. But they do very similar things. I would shed no tears for a Omnath ban. All right, we just need them to take like two more damage, and then we've got eight burn in our hand, huh? I'll get a Ren into Fairy before the extra card Omnath. There's two damage. I think that's a fine argument too. Although, like, I usually feel like I just want to ban Omnath because, like, Omnath gives them the most explosive turns. Omnath makes Yorion way better because all of a sudden Yorion is just like way less mana intensive. And if you ban Omnath, like, the deck actually can't be burned. The deck actually like goes from like 35% against burn to maybe 20% against burn, maybe like 15%, something like abysmal. No, do not ephemerate me. I'm gonna be so pissed. No, this is so frustrating. We just need them to not have exactly Solitude ephemerate after they shock here. This is ridiculous. I'm killing them next turn. Ugh, fuck. Guess I need to dart flashback dart on this before they have white mana. I have lethal? No, I don't have lethal. I can deal my opponent. I have 8 damage in hand. Chat, I can only deal 6 damage right now. I can deal 6 damage right now. But my opponent's going to gain 3 life. I don't have 3 mana. But I'm hoping my opponent shocks again, or I draw like another lava dart, and there's another, or they fetch twice. I'm not gonna bolt them. I'm gonna try to make them play into the double bolt, because playing around double bolt is kind of tough for them to do. Ugh, that's actually brutal that they're not fetching there. Although this is nice. So I don't need to bolt pre... Oh, hold on. When did I see this endurance? Fuck, I can't remember. I have to go back in the log. Oh, it's off the Oath of... It was off the Oath of Nissa. Okay. So I guess I just don't attack. I think I'm going to use the bolt. I mean, my opponent's just way, way less likely to fetch if I use the bolt. You know what I mean? Look here, I'll use it. They bounce their Oath of Nissa. Let me see what my top card is. Other Manamorphos. Well, we'll get to cycle twice as soon as we find a land. Oh, they've been bolt on Solitude, not Stone Rain myself. Well, I think the difference between like that one life is huge. Like, if my opponent just didn't have second Abundant Growth here, they would be dead. You know what I mean? It's like their mana base is so painful that the difference between that one damage mattered enough that I was happy enough to use the dart instead. And what's also kind of cool about dart is like my opponent is like way less likely to play around my last two cards being bolt if I use the dart there, if that makes sense. But here, land, lava dart, lightning bolt, monastery, swift spear are all potentially game ending draws. Yeah, no way they ever attack here. Let's go.
Oh.
What a game. Well, the one extra life didn't matter because I can just flash back to the dart. I don't know. I think it makes a lot of sense. Like, especially, again, like, what I really like about the dart, the solitude line, is my opponent is, like, way more likely to just fetch or fetch twice or shotgun a land to, like, cast an Omnath. And, like, it's so hard for them to put me on my last, my hand being bolt, especially when I didn't bolt the solitude. Yeah. I mean, I agree that it's obnoxious that the moons are just not that good against four color. I agree. I think I put back the mutagenic growth. It's kind of close. Kind of bad against Ren and Six on the channeler, potentially. I think I'm still playing channeler turn one. Well, I could play Swift Spear turn one. Yeah, I guess this is fine because I'm not really going to play either of these two drops next turn, probably, unless I draw Phoenix. And if I draw Phoenix, that's still fine. And then Channeler Bolt also helps me play around Solitude Ephemerate a little bit. I mean, I guess it doesn't matter that much either way. I think I'm holding the second Swift Spear. It's very close. But we've been Solitude Ephemerated both games, so let's not get Solitude Ephemerated this game. I mean, to all the people wanting Abundant Growth ban, think of all the Enchantress players, the poor, poor Enchantress players who would very, very unfairly be affected by the the Abundant Growth ban. I wonder if the new meta of, like, the four-color matchup is, like, you're the four-color deck, and you just know that your opponents never, ever bring in Blood Moon against you, so maybe you bring in the Magus of the Moon with that mindset. So I guess I should have bolted now, because if they have Fury, it's the same. If they have Solitude, they're going to get us right now anyways. Growth is medium enchantress. Yeah, I'm just teasing. Just teasing. I always feel like that's the worst argument. But what about this tier 3 deck that also uses this card? Think of them. The Marty Pyromancer players. I'm talking to you, Marty Pyromancer players. Y'all were ridiculous. Y'all were absolutely out of line during the Faithless Looting ban. Spike, how could you advocate for a Faithless Looting ban? I play Marty Pyromancer. Keep that on top, actually. Well, didn't find another land, but I guess that'll be okay. Ooh. I like that Phoenix. Probably not going to be useful this turn, though. Hopefully can set up for Phoenix next turn. Definitely with Metamorphose. How did Esper Leagues go? They went pretty well. I think we landed 11-4 on the day after three leagues. Decks felt very solid. Like, a lot of our losses were to, like, weird decks, too. Any changes to make to the Esper Food deck? I'm actually just pretty happy with the 75. I'm considering cutting the Shadow Spear from the main. That is one thing where, like, I don't tutor it that often. That being said, like, when you want to tutor it, you really want it to be there. You can, you know, theoretically connive it away. It is a one mana artifact, which is, you know, not so bad overall in the deck. But I feel like I even cited out against Hammer Time. Like, the main time you even want that card is the main time you want Shadow Spear is against Murktide, game one, when you have a hard time answering Murktide, but they have a hard time answering your construct, so you just make a big construct. Stupid Solitude Ephemerate. It's funny, I keep seeing me win Giant Trampling Construct. It doesn't happen that often. I mean, a lot of times I'll win with a Giant Trampling Construct, but, like, it won't at all be the deciding factor in me winning that game. But it'll be like what ends the game. Obviously you do it sometimes. So they're not playing their Rinnan 6, which is probably bad for me. They have a couple Bauble draws. I knew about that Manamorphose. I think that... my options here are to go Channeler, Manamorphose, Swift Spear, Manamorphose, Channeler, Dart, get Phoenix back. That seems pretty good. I do miss out on a couple Surveils, but I don't know that I need that many Surveils. Especially if it means my Swift Spear is a bit smaller. Not the worst draw. And then this is it's not great into Endurance, but I still get to attack for a ton. It is really bad into another Ephemerate, though. This line just, loses to another Ephemerate, I guess. Unless I mill over another Dart right now. Oh my gosh, I did it. How do you not take infinite mental damage playing versus this deck? Oh, I've developed a resistance, perhaps. Still take some. Seems like they've got the Endurance that they're tanking. Oh my gosh, they don't have it. So they have something. They didn't play the Rinnan 6, unless they just didn't think they wanted to fetch shock for Rin. So probably Eladomri's Call for Solitude. I don't need to do anything else because they put themselves to 9. I could just hit them for 8 and lava dart them. Okay. I don't know. I don't know, dude. Yeah, play around Weather the Storm. Dart is game. I know it's game, but I want my opponent to tap their mana first, right? Another freaking Yorion deck. Bolts out of paper. I have a foreign black boulder, foreign fourth edition bolts. I think they're Japanese. Second shredder. Stupid Rinnan 6. I think I'm not bolting the Rin yet. So I want to cast the shredder next turn, so I'm not going to go bolt untapped dart, so I'll just. Maybe focus the bolts at their face. Which becomes much more reasonable with 2 lightning bolts now in the hand. You will live. Ledger, Shredder, you're going to live. Do I like the new D&D bolts? I do like them. I haven't I've seen them just at the Magic Online arts, but I've been meaning to pick some up. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna bolt them. Connive. I think I'll discard the dart as kind of an investment for for later turns, so that I my shredder doesn't die to another bolt. Excuse me. And I like main phasing the bobble in case my opponent triggers connive. I have more information on what I want to discard. If my opponent wants Omnath, they do have to fetch shock. So if they go Omnath, they are going to have to also have a 0 mana elemental. Okay, just a ending. But I don't know why you fetch shock for that when you already have white mana off the growth. So must have Eladomri's Call in the hand. Which is bad. Nothing else really makes much sense. So let's go Hand Phoenix. And I can either go Swift Spear, Lightning Bolt, or I can go Bauble Salvaging. Oh yeah, they can't off the Steam Vents. Good call. I think I'm going to go Swift Spear, Lightning Bolt. Swift Spear, Bolt, Dart for lethal. Maybe Chat lethal, but that's 7 damage and they're at 8. Perhaps. Shot lethal. This is March? This line is way worse against March. On food made from Nymo, should I play Island? I would just play Darkslick Shores. Put Bobble in hand and it's lethal. That's true, yeah, that's true. But I think playing against playing around nothing when my opponent's shocked is probably not correct. Stupid Omnath.
I hate Omnath so much.
Okay. You know, we do have a Phoenix and a Salvaging in the hand. All hope is not lost, just like most we hope. I guess I could have also responded by salvaging Phoenix and try to find like another bolt to kill this. Do also really want to draw a spell off the salvaging right now. Maybe should have fetched first to increase those chances. Got there anyways. No more mountains. Okay. I'm gonna dart them now, try to mill another Phoenix into the yard. Get really high roll. Didn't quite, but I'll keep that for next turn. So Phoenix coming back. Oh, I was supposed to dart the Ren in 6. Oh no, I was supposed to dart Ren in 6. I guess I'll just attack the Ren. Maybe it's better to attack anyways, so that way I just like can ignore the Ren for the rest of the game. Although I'm cold to Solitude, and my opponent has they have the stupid Solitude. Oh, they don't have it. Just pausing for. Guess I wanted to see if they wanted to chump block. Winning this game would be wild.
Winning this game would be wild.
They just gain 7 life each turn. I know. I can also surveil, you know, multiple Phoenixes into the yard. We've got a chance. It's kind of copium, I guess. Okay, no Yorion in the hand is weird. And I'm drawing 2 cards this turn. And there's a chance. We do really need to like find a second Phoenix at least, and like soon, but. Or like find iteration here into some stuff. Definitely not land. Come on. Alright, well. I guess that's a place for a Phoenix to be, huh? Wait, didn't upkeep crack their fetch? Yeah, trying to do. I wanted to do a longer stream when I started today, but now I've got the. Gotta go by Micro Center. They do have endurance, so I guess that was actually the best place for Phoenix to be, huh? Okay. So they're just gonna kill both Phoenixes. Which I kind of love, unless there's like an ephemerate waiting for the to get rid of the Phoenixes, or like another endurance. But you know, I'm not beating that anyways. I'm never beating an ephemerate this game. All right, that is we definitely want them to just draw fetch lands because they have infinite fetch lands from the Ren. They do get to gain, you know, obviously an extra freaking 7 life or whatever. Oh, they could have just Yorion the endurance, but and I guess they still can. Stupid Yorion, stupid everything. All right, I yield. They're gonna get two. Like seeing the lightning bolt. This is something to make my mutagenic growths a bit better. Did we lose game one last time? I think we lost game one against 4 color and then just like no sideboard. One game's 2-3. What do you think of Ed winning another challenge? Not surprised. Ed is just like such a monster lately. That'd be hilarious. So the more enjoyable gameplay a four color can thrive. I don't love this argument. Like people have said this a lot. You ban Lurrus, four color Omnath gets to thrive. But Lurrus was played in Grixis Shadow, Hammer Time, Jun Saga. Those three decks, and all of those decks were Omnath's like best matchups. So like I don't really understand the argument. Like it's not like Omnath like already wasn't like a top deck before and continued to be a top deck after. I don't feel like the percentage points are maybe that different. Maybe they are. Maybe I could be wrong. But at the very least, like Omnath was really good against all of the Lurrus decks. So I feel like the Grixis Shadow fans upset at Omnath. I feel like the anger is misplaced. It made Bird worse, I guess, but not much worse. Especially because they don't have to worry about opposing Lurruses anymore. Plus on 2 dress down over a Grudge and a Growth, just so soft for a Sanctifier. Yeah, that could be a good option. That was kind of something I wanted to do earlier. Oh, there it is. They have a longtime deck specialist like Punt and the Sea of Tutors moving to play 4 color. I don't think you should read too much into it. Like... I think that nobody can really like play as much Magic as Punt and Deceive Tutors and like still play one deck nonstop, right? It's just like a nightmare to be a deck specialist and a content creator. You know what I mean? Like to just play one deck over and over again, like I don't think that you should read very much into like specific players switching decks. Yeah, Deceive is also not a one deck specialist, of course, but it's just like, well, okay. Well, I take everything back. That Fury makes me just like want to drop and drop and go pick up my stupid equipment. But we've got the prediction going, so we shouldn't, huh? Do I even like cast this Metamorphose? That was like such a brutal Fury. I guess I should have played around it, huh? Easy to complain. I should have like been more conscious of it. Whatever. I'm just casting my spells before conceding. Like, in paper on Magic Online, it's just so slow. It's so slow. I agree. Like, listen, I am not a defender of the deck. I'm not advocating for a ban. And I do think that the deck is like. It being in the metagame and like being like so popular is probably bad for the format overall. I'm on board with that thought at least. Do I hold the bauble to trigger prowess on my Swift Spear next turn? I think I'd rather find another one drop to play. If they have a removal spell, it's kind of the same, right? Tick tick for David. This is standard, by the way. You're gonna need a refund on this. Can we get a refund on that deck tech? I haven't paid any attention to standard in a long time. I cannot give you good and helpful insight on a standard deck. Ooh, well, I'm glad I played the bauble. You're wasting your channel points, although the Ahmad can get you those back. Decks are meant to be fun to play, not to be played against. I mean, people have this kind of attitude a lot. Listen, it's fine. Like, I think by itself, a deck being unfun to play should almost never be the deciding factor on if a deck gets banned or not. I think it should play a factor. It should maybe be closer to a tiebreaker if something's like very close to being banned, but boy, does it make gameplay miserable, then maybe just ban it, right? But I agree that I don't think that you should ban something just because it's unfun to play against. But if a deck is like, incredibly dominant and occupies a huge portion of the metagame share and is really fun to play against and is like limiting format diversity, then like maybe at that point that's when you start to be like, all right, well, no more something from the deck. I think I'm just gonna play second Swift Spear attack here. I mean, Lattice got banned? Yeah, listen, Lattice was also not banned just for it being unfun. Like, it was that was part of the reason in their you know, decision, their announcement, whatever. But like, Karn Lattice decks were really, really good, and they were really like miserable to play against. And like I feel like the fun argument. Why are they? I guess they're. I feel like these attacks with the Sentinels are just not that good. In fact, I'm gonna try to kill them. I'm just gonna give them the cards. I'm like one bolt or one dart from killing them here. I've got a lot of selection. Well, less selection now. Dang it. Okay. Let me actually give you those cards back. Yeah, give me those cards back, opponent. Yeah, KCI wasn't that dominate before it got banned. Yeah, but it was like, it's also like, again, that deck is like very, very good. It is like format warping in the sense that if you don't have like a lot of sideboard cards for KCI, you're just going to be like completely toast. You're going to be completely toast. And yeah, like also like sitting through like 10, 15 minute turns, just like, it's not a very good way to have your format be. All right, if I have a find a bolt, I guess I would have to find bolts. Good case errors, players are dominant. I don't think that that's really true. Like, you know, I teamed with one of the best KCI players in, you know, the whole format for the team Modern Pro Tour, Zach Elsick, who had just gotten second at like the SCG Invitational with it. And every single time we sat down for a match during that event, someone would whisper in the ears of whoever Zach's opponent was, whispering that they were playing. You know, he was playing KCI, and then they would go, "I know," and then they would mulligan to a good hand against KCI. And he had like a really bad record that weekend. He was like, I think he was like 4-12 that weekend or something. We had a good record overall, but he had a rough time. I really think at like at least at that pro tour, people were ready for KCI, and KCI did bad that weekend. How is that legal? That's at team tournaments, it's totally legal. Like, Zach had just gotten second at the SCG Invitational. He was like a pretty high profile player, and like knowing, like, if you know that if you're a teammate, you know who Zach is, and you should tell your teammate what you think they're on, and then the teammates all knew too. That's just part of team tournaments. Although I remember I played a couple team tournaments with like some of my more casual friends who are pretty good at Magic, but like, just, you know, are like more into like professional lives than Magic these days. Ooh, double grudge, one land though, on the play against Blue White Affinity. Get a mulligan. Yikes. And we played against like, we played against some like big pro teams. What a brutal, brutal. Give me that first hand back. We played against like Brad Nelson and like Yoel Larson and Seth Manfield. We played against that team. We played against another big pro team. I'm kind of blanking on who was on the other team. It was like one of the Japanese pros, and he was pairing with two like non-Japanese pros. I can't remember who they were. It's been a long time. But like my teammates had no idea we were playing against, you know, like Hall of Famers and stuff, because they just, you know, not that invested in the game. No. Is this where Reanimator still playable? It is, yeah. There's a lot of different ways to build a deck. It's also like really hot in the stream room here. Our AC like wasn't working last night in like this room and the master bedroom. I think it's like not working again. Yeah, the Texas heat's really rough. Esther actually grew up with no air conditioning, or like, so they had one like wall unit. What are these draws? What are these draws? Stop. they had one window unit. She's like not. She's not bothered by the lack of AC. Although it's only in those two rooms that the AC is not working. She said she was gonna call the AC people today, I think, but I don't know if she got around to it. I'll talk to her after the stream. But when does it pay out 2-2 and 3-2? It'll win. No, it's 2-2 or worse. So if I win this match, it's going to be 3-2. We can draw Grudge. We're playing its Divinity again. Yeah, we can't draw Grudge, but I don't even think that that's enough to get us out of that spot. The Shredder might be. Hopefully this weekend's like a little cooler. It's probably not going to be, though. Although, I guess we'll be inside in the ACL weekend. Oh, please play a second spell. Let's go. I think I play Iteration here. Hand, bottom, exile. And then we'll play Channeler. I'm pretty likely to discard my Shredder, although I could see, I mean, the Mutagenic Growth is important for spell count. I guess this Canal is pretty bad. Well, somehow I don't have an instant in the yard, but I can Mutagenic Growth my Channeler to make it a 5-5 on defense. But I feel like I probably just want to be more aggressive with it. It's supposed to rain Thursday, be a little cooler than Friday. Okay, awesome. Be good for Doomwake. Although Doomwake's room actually has like good AC. Could have Phoenix with Dart. I don't have with the Dart from the hand. Yeah, but the channel would like maybe even helps me find another Phoenix next turn. I don't know if I'm supposed to trade Mutagenic Growth for Frogbite here either. But then the four artifacts. It's pretty close. I think it's close. I think I'm gonna go for the defensive play here. And hope that the affinity count is relevant too. Although it doesn't seem to be too relevant against this Nettle Cyst. Draw an Arid Mesa for turn. Then the question becomes, I don't think I want to play the Shredder this turn. I think I want to try to find a spell off this Channeler, which I failed to do so, and then connive into something to get me back by Phoenix. Regretting losing the Mutagenic Growth now. Looking, I guess, mostly, oh yeah, Lava Dart is best draw, actually. So, guess we, I can't play the second Shredder this turn. So yeah, I'll just discard the Shredder. If I discard the Mountain, I can't play the Shredder. I don't want to kill a Minmite. I think I'll kill a Minmite. If I kill a Minmite, my Swissweaver becomes 2-3, 3-4. Keep that on top. And then I can Lava Dart this. So that if they block the Germ Token on the Swift Spear, they trade. And if not, I get to hit them for 3 more, which I think is fine. And then I can play the Arid Mesa and shuffle away my Lightning Bolt if I feel like I no longer want it, but I'm probably going to want it. Couldn't you have discarded Dart and kept Shredder? I could have, but then I don't get my Phoenix back. I needed the Dart to be 2 spells for Phoenix. Yeah, no, the only instant sorcery was the Metamorphose. They do trade with the Swift Spear, which I think is really good for me. They're at a nice, clean multiple of 3, and I have a Lightning Bolt on top of my library and 3 flying 3/3s. Why not Dart in response? In response to what? I needed to Dart main phase. Oh, well, there goes the Bolt. I needed to Dart main phase so that I could get my Phoenix back. I don't know what I'm responding to, though. All right, Urza concede. 4 grudges, -3 growths, -1 salvaging, submit button. Yeah, I think everybody forgot the Phoenix because it got discarded like turn 2. I think that after today, I'm feeling pretty happy about wanting to register Esper Cookbook for Dreamhack. Maybe tomorrow I need to go to Micro Center and try to get equipment to film with. Maybe I take Hitachi up on his offer to borrow the equipment, but I feel like if I'm settled on a deck for tomorrow, I'm going to need to have some brews for the rest of this week, so I need to spend some time prepping, and I also have to do my Channel Fireball video tonight. Just kind of thinking out loud, planning the week. I've got okay. I'll show you the reward to people who stayed till the end of the stream. I've had this deck built for a little while. It looks like such an abomination. I've had this list built for a little while. I haven't play tested it yet, but it's a 4-color Wilderness Reclamation check, trying to capitalize on Riveteer's Charm, and specifically I just really want to snapcast a Riveteer's Charm. I think that might be good. It's kind of an abomination. It looks really, really fun though. Yeah, it looks really awful. I'm going to play test it off stream, see if it's better than it looks. This deck probably never sees the stream. Maybe you'll see me. I do think Push is really good in Reclamation though. It's like way better than the red removal spells. But I mean, more than less likely, this is not a deck that I ever go live with. but I've been meaning to playtest it. See if it's just a little better than it looks. Right, just make them pop the relic, although it's questionable if I'm supposed to wait on this and like make them tap the mana in their upkeep versus the one damage. It'd be better to just make them tap the mana. Why does it need to be all four? It doesn't. I don't know why these are the arts that I got selected. And I'm playing two Nexus of Fates in case I accidentally exile one to charm. And I'm playing Remand because I think it's a little bit better with the color requirements. But it is kind of awkward to have Remand and Charm in the same deck, admittedly. Having to play Remand is also kind of like a... kind of yikes. Is Hall the win con? The win con is just taking infinite turns and going in on Renin 6. Renin 6 either recurring the Lightning Bolt and killing your opponent or just pinging infinite after taking infinite turns. You also have Snapcasters, but maybe that's kind of a meme. I think I make red-blue here. It's kind of close. Yikes. Yikes, yikes. So many looks at a land and failed to find one. There aren't any bolts in the deck. All right, there are bolts in a different version. But yeah, just Renin 6. Just like taking infinite turns is your win condition with Renin 6. You have two Nexus of Fates. You will get to infinite turns in the late game. The win condition, or just sorry, Fire Ice. Fire Ice is the burn spell with Renin 6.
Do you want to set up mowing weekly or bi-weekly?
Bi-weekly.
Okay, it's
40
weekly,
50
bi-weekly.
Okay, it's
160
weekly,
100
bi-weekly.
Per month?
Mm-hmm.
I see.
Yeah. Okay. Focus up, I need to win the game. I mean, what do you want me to do? I got no actions left. I have to win game 3, really. Yeah, I don't know how I'm supposed to win this game. All right, for all the marbles. Maybe we'll just play Hollow Vine tomorrow. I've been liking that deck so much, the Hollow Shredder Vine deck. It'll just be a fun Wednesday. Maybe if I record my Channel Fireball deck, this deck totally obviously crashes and burns and is terrible. And then I don't figure out a non-reclamation version. And I don't have any other ideas. And I get an existential crisis and I have no content. Then we'll just play Hollow Vine tomorrow. Play food deck. I played it like I played three leagues of it today. It's also like I've kind of been a bit saturated on that stream wise, and I've also played like enough of that deck that I'm not like. It's not one that I feel. I think I'm gonna grudge this. Just grudge pass. Get their affinity down. Make my channeler better. Oh, I guess we keep that on top. Yeah, just keep it on top. I don't feel like I need more practice on it. I think I'm playing it as well as I can play it. But no, since I played Sack, yeah, I was kind of wanting to return to Sack. That's true. Thanks for that reminder. I was kind of looking to like still be on like either like Jun Sack with Tenacious Underdog or like just a slightly tweaked red black version. But I do feel like I agree that there's more wiggle room here, dude. My favorite thing to do in modern is to surveil a Phoenix into the yard when I have a DRC in play. It is just like, it's just, there's nothing like it. Oh, I meant to make green mana. I guess I can still make green. Maybe it's not good to kill this, but I feel like I want to use the Metamorphose to flashback the grudge because I don't currently have my Stomping Ground, and I guess I'll also just hold the iteration for next turn and hold up the one mana dart. Did you guys know that Treasure Vault is actually not indestructible? Darksteel Citadel is indestructible. However, Treasure Vault, quite destructible. Yeah, quite structible indeed. Then need another green mana to flash back the second grudge, but drawing double grudge against Divinity feels great. I am feeling good about my choice for the Esper food deck. I need to ask Doom if I can maybe borrow some cards if my cards don't come in the mail. I need to get streaming equipment. I need to channel Fireball video. I need to brew. Gonna have a busy night. Busy night. What do you think of the Rectus Midrange Deck of Pioneer? I think it's good. I think you have a lot of flexibility in how you can build it as well. It's a deck I would recommend. So two darts is 4 plus 6 is 10. So I think I just bolt them. I can hardcast the Phoenix next turn. And I'll flashback grudge on the drum. Because who cares about this Frogmite? Not me. Okay, where did this copypasta come from? Everyone should miss the Oko Uro meta. It's one of the most interactive, interesting, and deep metas in a while, and everyone just plays mono four color Omnath. You couldn't get free easy wins before like you can now. Who started this? Or is it just like an ironic posted a couple times ago and I'm calling it copypasta? I saw it posted twice, so I assumed it was a pasta, but maybe it was like one serious post followed by you know, someone posting it. Shredding Spree worse than Grudge. In this deck, when you have Shredder and Channeler, like the fact that you can flashback Grudge is just so nice. And instant speed against Hammer Time is really, really relevant. Okay, 3-2 this league. I'm really happy with the food choice. I love you, NordVPN. You're my hero. It's so hot in this room. The air conditioning is just not on at all. I'm going to go to a different room where it's cooler and get my brain back. But until then, I want everybody to go give Demonic Tutors a big kiss on the cheek. Say, I love you, Ed. You're the best Magic player there is. How do you win every challenge you ever play? If you're not following Ed, you're making a big mistake. Ed is just like...